الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد, we're still going through سورة آل عمران from the تفسير of الشيخ العلامة الشيخ عبد الرحمن بن ناصر السعدي رحمه الله. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he is speaking here about عيسى عليه السلام and how Allah blessed him with so many blessings. From them, he said he will teach him the book, which may refer to any generic book. So Allah specifically mentioned the Torah and the Gospel. See, we Muslims, alhamdulillah, we believe in the Torah, we believe in the Gospel, as Allah revealed them, without being altered. Because they have been altered and tempered with. But the original form, we believe in it. Alhamdulillah. And it's very easy for us to call them to Islam. Very easy for us to call them to Islam. Walillahi alhamd. Some of them, when you share with them some of the verses of the Quran, they're shocked. They said, I've never heard anything like this. Because to them, They have been actually deceived by the priest. They deceived them. And they taught them the wrong information about Isa alayhi salam being the son of God and all this trinity and all this stuff. But alhamdulillah, when you read the Quran, it's very clear. Isa alayhi salam, he was no more than a prophet, messenger, a servant of Allah. He was not God or son of God or anything like that. The Sheikh said, because both these scriptures have a very high stature and reverence, they contain the commandments and the doctrines that the prophets from the children of Israel used as a source for their judgment. Giving knowledge includes knowledge of both the text and its meaning. It is also possible that he will teach him the book refers to the skill of writing, because knowledge and the ability to write is one of the greatest blessings of Allah on his servants. That is why Allah has particularly described the blessing of granting them knowledge through the pen, as mentioned in the very verse revelation to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم. Read in the name of your Lord, who created man from a clot of blood. Read, your Lord is the most generous, who taught by means of the pen. Allahu Akbar. So these were the first ayat that were revealed to the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from Surah Al-Alaq. Surah Al-Alaq. So the first five ayat of Surah Al-Alaq that were revealed to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he was in the cave of Hira, when Jibreel came to him and he said, read. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ma ana biqari', I don't know how to read. So al ulama, they mention here that there is a great benefit, there's a great benefit for that, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not know how to read. Because if he knew how to read, they would have said this Quran is from him, he fabricated it. But since he did not know how to read, there is no way that they can accuse him of fabricating the Quran. And that's why they say he's sahir. They say he's a magician. How is he a magician? Because they say he separates between the son and the father, the daughter and the mother, and the like. But the reality, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from his name, Al-Mufarriq. Al-Mufarriq, the one who divides the truth from falsehood. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So if your child accepted Islam and accepted Tawheed, are you going to blame Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for that? Because you don't want to accept the truth? And you want to remind upon وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ shirk وَالْكُفْرِ Allahu Akbar. So that's why you find some of the Sahaba, their fathers, they were the leaders of Quraysh, the enemies of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And some of them, like Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, his son, he was one of the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And his father, he was the leader of the hypocrite. Subhanallah. Look at that. يُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ Allahu Akbar. Allah brings out the living from the dead. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. So we find this a lot. You find families, they have children who are Muslims, and their parents, they're upon shirk. And you find even among the people of the Sunnah, because I get a lot of questions. Like you find sometimes the children, they are upon Tawheed, upon Sunnah, and the father and the mother, they're grave worshippers. Yeah, grave worshippers, subhanallah. So there's a conflict, there's a aqidah conflict in the household between the people of Tawheed and the people of Shirk, subhanallah. Allah guides whom He wills. So these five ayat, Surah Al-Alaq, were the first ayat that were revealed to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was in the cave of Hira. And if you pay attention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He started out with knowledge. Read. Shows you that one of the means of learning is reading the books. Reading the Quran. Reading the books of Hadith. Reading the books of the scholars. For those who were with us last night here, we had a good session, by the way. We had a very good session, right, Brother Adam?
Yeah.
Brother Muhammad? So you enjoyed it? Your kids enjoyed it? MashaAllah. We had a good session, alhamdulillah. We were studying a very small treatise. It's actually a poem. It's a poem in the foundations of fiqh. So when you come out of the masjid and you have learned a foundation and you start understanding the religion better. You know, you have guidelines, you have principles, you have foundations. So you're not going to be chaotic. You know exactly how to deal with every situation when it comes along, you know? Knowledge is, subhanallah, as Al-Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah, he said, لَوْلَا الْعُلَمَاء لَوْلَا الْعُلَمَاء بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَمَنِّهِ لَكَانَ النَّاسِ مِثْلَ الْبَهَائِمِ He said, if it was not for the scholars, by the grace of Allah and His mercy, the people will be like cattle, right or wrong. Yes, they will be like cattle. Because how would you know tafsir al-Quran if you didn't have scholars? You're not going to understand al-Quran without Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiyallahu anhuma. You're not going to understand al-Quran without Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Ali ibn Abi Talib, Ubay ibn Ka'b, right? And another thing also, the Sahaba, radiyallahu anhum, they documented Al-Quran. They documented Al-Quran and they sacrificed Allah. And that's why they are better than us. And we can never be like them. We can never be like the companions, radiallahu anhu. Allah has chosen them for this task of preserving and documenting and safeguarding Al-Quran. Allahu Akbar. But even though, subhanallah, they didn't have the technology that we have today, but yet they had the zeal, they had the love, devotion, So they documented the Quran, even though at that time there were only primitive conditions. They were not like what we have today. It's easier to document. But subhanAllah, imagine they used flat bones, flat stones, and the like to write down the Quran, document the Quran on it. So Sahaba, they went through a lot. They went through a lot. But Allah raised their status. Allah raised their status. That you see here, the importance of taking from the companions. Importance taken from the companions. Because a lot of people, they say, Kitab was Sunnah, and they stop right there. No. You got to go beyond that. It is Kitab was Sunnah based on the understanding of the Sahaba. Why is that? Because the Sahaba are the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they are also his students. And they learned directly from him. They were there. They witnessed the revelation. They witnessed every action, every movement of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they documented everything. And that's why in hadith, subhanallah, you find they are very meticulous, aren't they? They will mention everything about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The way he looked, the way he talked, the way he walked, everything, subhanallah, is documented about the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You would not find any nation, the Christian, the Jews, the Hindu, you name it. They will not have books like al-Bukhari, al-Muslim, al-Nasa'i. They don't have books very detailed about the Prophet Messenger. You're not gonna find it. Except Muslims. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he started with these ayat. So the ulama, they say the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he became a prophet with this ayat from Surah Al-Alaq. اقرأ بِاسْمِ رَبِّكَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ. So he became a prophet. He became a prophet. What is the difference between a prophet and messenger? Anybody knows?
The one that reveals the book is the messenger.
The one that has a book to deliver, yes. Ahsant. طيب. And the prophet, what does he do?
He gives the da'wah.
He gives da'wah, and also he confirms the book that came before him. Like, for example, the prophet that came after Musa alayhi salam. Like Samuel, right? Samuel in Surah Al-Baqarah. Like the story of Bani Israel when they asked their prophet Samuel to send a king for them to fight Jalut, Goliath. You know that story, right? In Surah Al-Baqarah. So that prophet, Samuel, he did not bring a book. He did not bring something new. He just confirmed the Torah, right? That's a prophet. So the Messenger of Allah, he became a prophet with this ayat from Surah Al-Alaq, and he became the Messenger of Allah with what surah? Anybody knows? What surah? He became the Messenger of Allah. Think about it. Yes, Al-Muddathir, Ahsant. Surah Al-Muddathir. Ya ayyuha Al-Muddathir, Qum fa'andir. Qum fa'andir. Ya ayyuha Al-Muddathir. Al-Muddathir is the one who is wrapped up. Because what happened to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Anybody knows what happened to him in the cave? And he went to Khadija. He was shivering.
He was
shaking and shivering, right? And he said, Zammiluni. Cover me up. That's why Allah said, Ya ayyuhal muzzammil. The one who's wrapped up. Right? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhal muddathir. Or the one who's wrapped up in his garment. Naam? Or blanket. Qum fa'andir. Stand up, arise, and warn your people. So he became the Messenger of Allah with this ayat from Surah Al-Muddathir. Allahu Akbar. But look at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was alone with Khadija radiallahu anha. And then his cousin Ali ibn Abi Talib. And Abu Bakr Siddiq. Little by little, little by little. Look now. Look at his ummah now. Everywhere you go. Even the Eskimos, they have some of the Muslims there. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal al-salih. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Jazakum Allah khair. Barakallahu feekum.